Apart from the J-seals, there are other implants and seals which affect our DNA template. These seals and energetic implants also include metatronic implants, Templar seal, Templar axion seal, cell death programs, apoptosis, crown of thorns, and the Zeta seal. Metatronic implants are known as the tree of artificial life. They are a series of implants designed to rapidly reverse the activating template into metatronic fall. It is the reverse shadow body as opposed to the ascending, evolving 12-dimensional body. Metatron was an entity that fell due to code convolution. The metatronic structure sucks energy to be immortal. Templar seal and Templar axion seal involved the removal of the sixth base tone of DNA strand 2, the sixth overtone from strand 4 and the 12th overtone of strand 5 in the sixth dimension. In the seventh dimension, it involved the removal of the sixth base tone of the first DNA strand, the sixth base tone of the fifth strand, and the sixth base tone of the sixth DNA strand. This is the original meaning of the biblical reference to 666. It is the reason why humanity has been asleep, buried in religion's persuasive story of a wrathful, judgment-oriented God, unable to integrate higher frequencies for ascension. Cell death programs is apoptosis, what science terms as cells committing suicide. Science believes apoptosis is normal, but it was never intended by Source, God, for us to die and reincarnate. Cell death programs has shortened humanity's lifespan and kept humanity incarnating. The crown of thorns is an energy configuration above the head of humans that distorts the natural energetic circulatory system and blocks the receiving of the primal life force currents from your higher self and Source, God. The crucifixion was an energetic crucifixion to humanity, as the crown of thorns scrambles the universal currents to our chakras, keeping humanity stuck in a third-dimensional frequency fence. Once this is cleared, many feel or see a metal plate being removed from above their head. Zeta seal is located in the fourth DNA strand, which blocks a person's ability to evolve towards frequencies of unconditional love and higher dimensions. The fifth DNA strand is blocked from plugging into any of the lower strands. It's a frequency fence. All beings born since 1748 AD have this Zeta seal distortion. It has created a blockage from experiencing astral awareness, astral travel, lucid dreaming, out-of-body experiences, intuitive gifts, and causing difficulty in remembering dreams. Original Divine Template. The original divine template for human progression was a natural unfolding of higher consciousness in one lifetime. For example, at age 12 your soul body would be activated, which corresponds to DNA strands 4, 5, and 6. At the age of 22, your oversoul body would be activated, which corresponds to DNA strands 7, 8, and 9 would activate. At the age of 33, your Christos avatar body would be activated, which corresponds to the activation of DNA strands 10, 11, and 12. By the age of 44, your Rishi body would be activated, which corresponds to DNA strands 13, 14, and 15. This natural process is the embodiment of one's higher consciousness, also known as ascension. Since the majority of humanity is unable to activate strand 4 during adolescence, the chemicals back up in the DNA, creating all kinds of weird emotional issues and physical imbalances. This is not natural. Strand 4 never gets activated, and thus a person never activates their soul identity. Thus they have no idea why they incarnated here, what they are here to do, and cannot even connect to and listen to their higher self because their seven higher senses are not active. If these unnatural seals are not cleared, then biological death is inevitable. Yet biological death is not natural to our angelic human DNA or indigo DNA templates. We are meant to biologically ascend, which is the accretion of light to transform the body into light, not drop the body and leave it behind. This sounds too weird and unbelievable. It is easy to understand why a person would be skeptical of something they cannot see with their physical eyes. I have learned over the course of my life to trust my intuition, as my intuition and feelings have always been correct. Sometimes what we see is opposite of what we feel. For example, your partner may tell you that he or she honors sexual fidelity in your relationship, yet you feel this is a lie. Why? A person can lie, but their energy will always tell the truth. When you use your inward wisdom, you are connecting to this energy signal that speaks the truth. Michael Talbot explains in his book The Holographic Universe, we are perceivers. We are an awareness. We are not objects. We have no solidity. We are boundless. The world of objects and solidity is a way of making our passage on Earth convenient. Even if unnatural seals clearing sounds odd, trust your intuition, for we are perceivers.